So it looks like Matt Reeves actually rejected the Ben Affleck Batman script to make his Batman movie. Hey, welcome back to the Ping Pong Flix. My name is Chris Wong. First, we're going to talk about Matt Reeves, the Batman, and how he got the gig. Then we're going to talk about possible new Batman scenes in the Ayer Cut of Suicide Squad. Alright, let's talk about Matt Reeves the Batman. So Matt Reeves the Batman is coming out in March 4th. It's got a lot of exposure right now. There's a lot of promotions. There's a new posters. There's a lot of TV spots. So if you don't want to see anything about that, get off the internet because they are showing a lot of new scenes. And with a little bit more than a month away till we get to see Matt Reeves the Batman in theaters, it's now being revealed by Esquire how Matt Reeves got the gig. Now, previously we knew that Matt Reeves was brought in to do the Batman, but then he walked away because he needed his creative freedom. And creative freedom is what he got when he finally signed up. Well, now we're getting actual details of what actually happened. Now, Matt Reeves was working on his Planet of the Apes movies at that time when Warner Brothers called him to do something with Batman. Now, in his mind, he already envisioned some type of Batman story that he've always wanted to make, which is what we're going to be getting in March, but at that time Warner Brothers handed him the Ben Affleck Batman script. I read a script that they had that was totally valid take on the movie. It was very action driven. It was very deeply connected to the DCEU with other major characters from other movies and other comics popping up. I just knew that when I read it, this particular script was not the way I'd want to do it, Reeves explains. And when he means major characters popping up, I'm going to guess that's probably Deathstroke. It had Batgirl, may have had Harley Quinn, Joker, who knows? And this is the part where he respectfully said no to the project. I said, look, I think maybe I'm not the person for this. And I explained to them why I love this character. I told them that there have been so many great movies, but if I were to do this, I'd have to make it personal so that I understood what I was going to do with it, so that I know where to put the camera, so that I know what to tell the actors, so that I know what the story should be. This take, I told them, pointing at the script, is a totally valid and exciting take. It is almost James Bondian, but it wasn't something that I quite related to, Reeves says. James Bondian. That's an interesting way to look at a Batman story. God, if they're not going to do Ben Affleck's Batman movie, I would love to see that script. So what I'd love to do, if you're interested, is I'd like to get involved and find a way to take the story and make it a very, very personal and get to the place I want him to be, to make it a Batman story and give him the arc and have the story rock him to his core. It wasn't going to be another origin story, not with Ben already in the character, but that's what I would do, Reeves told them. And in a way, just trying to like walk out the door, he continued. I said, but here's the other thing. This is why I think you're not going to want me to direct this movie. I can't even tell you what that story is for months because I have to finish this Apes movie. And to my utter shock and surprise, they said, you know what? We really would like you to do this and we will wait. And wait they did because beginning of 2017, Ben Affleck was starting to walk away from the Ben Affleck Batman movie. We had no idea what was going on. Dylan Clark, Reeves' longtime producing partner, tells us, Ben is a friend of mine and I love Ben, but I didn't know exactly about those things were happening in his personal life. We didn't find out until much later. Which is would be at this time where Ben Affleck said no to the whole Batman thing altogether, leaving Matt Reeves open with a blank slate. So it's pretty tough to hear that we could have got a James Bondian DCEU Batman story with multiple DCEU characters showing up. I think that would have been awesome if Ben Affleck's heart was still in it. But unfortunately, his heart is not in it anymore, and so now we're left with Matt Reeves the Batman, which looks awesome, by the way. I think this movie is going to be great. I think Robert Pattinson is going to be a terrific Batman. All the trailers and TV spots I'm seeing looks phenomenal. I mean, heck, Zack Snyder is even excited about it and he can't wait to see it. So yeah, I would totally love to get Ben Affleck's Batman, but for now, we're having Matt Reeves the Batman come out on March 4th. Alright, let's talk about the Ayer Cut of Suicide Squad. So there might be another way to actually see more of Ben Affleck's Batman, I think. Currently, there are no plans to release the Ayer Cut of Suicide Squad right now. And with the help of David Ayer and the cast and crew from Suicide Squad, we're beginning to put together the pieces of what was missing in the theatrical cut. And it looks like there might be some more Ben Affleck Batman after all. This is coming from the Ayer Cut account. This gentleman by the name of Owen, who's holding the laptop there, a crew member from the original 2016 Suicide Squad, had a message to share with the Ayer Cut account. Hey Owen, since you have seen David's cut in full, are there any cool things you can share that didn't happen in the theatrical or any more Batman scenes? And Owen said, dream sequence. Dream sequence. There's going to be more Batman scenes as a dream sequence? Now, the only thing I can think of having a dream sequence with Batman in it, where Enchantress gave Will Smith's Deadshot a dream that he kills Batman. But that was so short-lived and there was nothing much of that. Maybe there was a bigger fight. You know, a little bit more of that alleyway fight. Or, as fans have suggested, maybe this clue from David Ayer himself will be where we actually get more of those Batman scenes. David Ayer had posted a while back saying dream, and it shows Jared Leto's cutscene of him as Joker with half of his face burnt. So maybe at this point in time, Enchantress gives him a dream as well as the rest of the Suicide Squad members, a dream where Joker kills the Batman. That could be the case. I could certainly see that, seeing that everybody else has their dream that they want happen. And that would be really cool to see if that were the case. Jared Leto's Joker interacting with Ben Affleck's Batman. Something that we would have seen before that interaction they do in the nightmare sequence of Zack Snyder's Justice League. Well, hopefully someone leaks that out one day. I would truly love to see that interaction. If Ben Affleck's Batman is in a new dream sequence, that would be so cool. But in any case, it would be cool to see another lost footage of Ben Affleck as Batman. Alright, what do you think about Matt Reeves rejecting the Ben Affleck Batman script to make his own Batman movie? And also, what do you think about that potential new Batman dream sequence that's supposedly in David Ayer's Suicide Squad? Share your thoughts in the comments down below.